now it's time for our children's moment. This is the time during our online worship where we have a lesson for the kids. Now our lesson this week is about a holiday that is coming up next week. Do you know what holiday I'm talking about? I've got a hint for you right here. What holiday do you think is coming up based on these eggs? It's Easter. Easter will be next Sunday and we get to celebrate that. But what are we celebrating on Easter? I know usually when we have holidays, we're kind of celebrating a certain thing, like Christmas. We celebrate that God sent Jesus as a baby to live on earth with us. And say New Year's Day, we celebrate the start of a new year. Or maybe my birthday, we celebrate the day that I was born. But on Easter, what are we celebrating? Are we celebrating eggs? No. Are we celebrating toys and candy inside of the eggs? No. Are we celebrating a bunny? No, not really. On Easter, we're celebrating something really special and really important. We're celebrating Jesus. On Easter, we get to celebrate that Jesus gave his life for us, that he died for us. But not just that he died, that he rose again. He defeated death. So I've got some objects here that are going to help me tell that part of this story, the part where Jesus gave up his life for us. We're going to try and understand why Jesus had to die and why it was so special that he rose again and what we celebrate on Easter. Let's look. All right, we've got a science experiment set up here to help us understand a little bit more about why Jesus had to die. We'll start with a penny. I'm going to put the penny on this plate here. And this penny represents people, like me or you. And the plate represents our world. When God first created our world, it was perfect. But then sin entered our world, and we were separated from God because God can't be around sin. Everyone has sin in their life. Sin is anytime we do anything against what we know God wants us to do. When we turn to other things to make us feel happy or complete. You see how the penny is completely surrounded by sin? It's covered up by it. The Bible says in Romans 3:23, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." The price of sin is death. Now, God knew we would need some help with paying that price so that we could remove that separation between us and God. So God sent us Jesus. This candle here is going to represent Jesus. Jesus came to earth to live with us. He came among us and lived as a man. Jesus came to show us how to live. He came to shine his light and point us towards God. But he didn't just come to be an example. Jesus also came to help us out with that price that we really can't pay, the price of sin. So Jesus, in his life, after he showed us all how to live, Jesus paid the ultimate price. You see, Jesus gave up his life for us. And whenever he did that, he took on all the sin of the world. His life paid the price for everyone. He paid this price forever and ever and ever, not just one time, but all times. For every sin from every person forever and ever and ever. Jesus defeated death. And that's what we celebrate on Easter, that Jesus defeated death. He paid the price that we couldn't pay, and he removed that block between us and God so that we could be with God forever. And that is worth celebrating. So next week on Easter, let's celebrate that Jesus died and that he rose again. Have a great week. I'll see you again soon.